Howdy everybody, Steve here, KM9G. Today is the tale of two radios. I finally have in my hot little hands a Xiegu X6200 that is not the prototype model. So no prototype sticker on the top, and now I got a big thumbprint on the front of it. Let me get this thing over to the workbench. I'm gonna show you the power output, and I'm going to show you some of the differences between the two units. There are definitely some differences. The prototype model is definitely a prototype, and this is why I haven't shared with you some of the things that this radio can do, because it wouldn't be fair. They sent me, in confidence, a prototype model to share with you guys ahead of production units, and the production units are actually a little bit different in some ways. So let's go take a look. Here it is. We have the prototype version and the not-so-prototype version. And we're gonna talk about some of the differences between the two, which there really aren't that many. The top hatch on the prototype and the non-prototype, it is, actually, I gotta tighten that up. I loosened it up and I put it back on, but it's a little cockeyed, so I gotta fix that. There's still nothing under there. That is still a solid piece of metal underneath of the hatch, and I thought that was going to be the upgrade port. The other thing is power output. So I'm gonna turn both of these on in the same way at the same time. And the light for the prototype is a little dimmer than the light for the regular. And it looks like the regular, the shipping production model, is booting much faster. Or, you know, just booting. All right, so that one's all the way up and running, and this one didn't go anywhere. Let's turn that volume down. Yeah, this one just lit up and didn't go anywhere. So the booting problems appear to have been solved in the production run. Hold this down until it either lights up with a screen or shuts itself off completely. All right, it went off completely. Let's turn it back on. It clicked. There it is. And it might have rebooted a second time, all on its own. This looks a little more promising. A third time? All right, and we are up and running. We'll do the same thing. We'll turn the volume down, and it says power on test, power on it, so it's still booting. Trying to sort out what kind of power it's on. We got the power all the way down. This one is 4 watts. Let's go into settings, and let's do, well, first of all, let's turn that back off. It's a little weird to me to do that. There's an inner knob and an outer knob, and the inner knob controls the setting, and the outer knob controls which setting you want to go to. So I'm going to put that all the way up, and you push the knob in, and then it becomes your quick go-to. So you can see these are both on battery power. There's nothing connected. This one says 5 watts. This one says 4 watts. The screens look to be identical to me. Let's get, we're at 14270 there. Let's get to 14270 here. And the reason why I want to be at the same place in the band is because they have this band plan up here in the color section. So it is yellow, orange, and blue to tell you what color it is. And I just wanted to make sure that those colors were the same so that wasn't freaking people out. This one is at 7.9 volts. I have used this on battery a bit. This one is at 8.2 volts. And this one has its Wi-Fi enabled. There is a screen protector on there. Not anymore, that's gone. So we already have the 5 watts out on battery power on the production model. I'm gonna test that here coming up in a bit. And I wanna show you the power output on this one here as well. Let's check system. And let's go to system info. System info. So this has a newer firmware on it than this one does, which would explain why it booted up faster. So we are at version 1.0, and this is something that Xiegu did in the last revision. I noticed that Josh from Ham Radio Crash Course had a version that had newer firmware on it than mine, but still had the same firmware version number. So these are all version 1.0 for the app firmware, FPGA, and hardware. And then the dates, the production model is May 30th, 2024 at 10:54:39. Versus the prototype is May 14th, 2024 at 9:53 for the app. And then for the firmware, it's May 29th, 2024. And for the firmware, it's May 8th, 2024. So the older dates are on the prototype model. And I got this before the end of May. So, you know, they couldn't put firmware on it that didn't exist at the time. Exit, exit. So the buttons are still a little interesting. And I have changed, let me go in and do a factory reset on this one because I have changed some settings. And that's going to change the way the screen looks. Factory reset, okay. Okay again. And it looks like this requires a reboot. Okay, and now this says 5 watts on battery power, and it did not say that before. But we're gonna test the power output. Maybe, and I will take full responsibility for this, maybe it shipped with 4 watts as the setting. There it is, never mind. Nothing to take responsibility for, it's all good. Okay, so what I have is the N6ARA Morse code paddle, and I am going to set this up for straight key mode. Key type manual. I'm going to change the mode on the radio to be CW. There's a quick button on top to switch to CW mode. So now we're in CW mode for both of these. And I am going to plug in to shore power here for this test. So let's do the prototype version first. And you guys have been asking me to do a power test, and there's a reason why I didn't do the power test. So right now what we're going to do is hit record on the second camera, and the second camera will show you the MFJ power meter, and we are connected to a dummy load, and we are connected to an Astron RS35A, so a 35 amp power supply. I'm going to plug this into the key port and then key down. And you can see the power meter is taking a minute to warm up, and this is not normal for radios. It takes a little while to get up, and we are hunting for 4 watts, and we hit 4 watts. Okay. So we get the rated output power of 4 watts. Now let's change the, okay, that's a coarse measurement, and then use the outside lower knob. And it is finicky. Oh, maybe because it's not in general. There it is. Okay, so now we're back to general. So max output power on shore power is 8 watts. And let's go back to the camera on the MFJ meter. And again, it takes it a minute to climb up. And this should be fairly instant. And we're above the 8 watts. And it looks like it's dancing back and forth around 830, 833, 835. Yeah, it just keeps getting better and better. It keeps putting out more power. But you're not gonna key down that long. You're gonna say a word and unkey. You're gonna press the paddle and unkey. You're gonna do whatever it takes to do that kind of thing. This, again, is the power output on the prototype on 20 meters. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna turn this, no, I'm not gonna turn it off because it takes forever to turn back on. We're gonna plug in the production model and we're gonna run the same test. Now it says 5 watts on battery power. So let me unplug the shore power real quick. Get that out of the way and plug in the antenna, plug in the key. And just for grins, we'll be on 14270 as well. Let's look at the other camera. Still takes a second to get up to power levels. But we're on battery power 4.98, 5.02. So it is doing 5 watts out on battery power like it says. It's doing more than 5 watts out on battery power. 530, 533, 535, 538, 540. So it's doing higher power than expected while at the same time not delivering power instantly. Key off, key on. Okay, so it's not bad once it gets going. key, 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 key. It's not bad once it gets going. Now let's plug it into shore power and see what our max power output is on shore power. Go back to see if that works first. Yeah, see, that's changing my key type. So we go back to general, and now it'll change the power. And max output on shore power is 8 watts. Let's check our other camera. And then it's cooled down enough that it takes some time to warm up again. 9 watts, still climbing. Okay, so back down to 8.5, 8.6. It looked like something just happened that dropped it back down. Starting to climb up again. I would not advise that you do this on your radio. I wouldn't advise that you key down for this length of time. 8.92, 8.95, 8.97. Okay, so unkey. 8.6, 8.5, rekeying. You can see the red light come on in the Xiegu name there. 8.28. Let's give it a good 10 count. Key down, 7.5. So 10 second cool off, and it's dropping its power by half a watt according to what it says. But we were at 8.5 before. So it'll climb up. Let's go back into key and change this to auto left. And let's turn the volume up so I can hear myself. Key speed is off for me. Let's turn that up a bit so you guys can hear it. All right. That's probably me on this key. I'm getting used to this new key from N6ARA. So that's a look at the power meter during a CQ call on CW at 20 words per minute using an iambic paddle. So you can see what the power looked like when we did that. One of the other things that happened, and I don't know, let's put this on the other, let's go back to the prototype and see if we can replicate this. In the field, when I did my field test with a real antenna, let's check our noise floor. Let's turn the volume down on that one. Turn the volume up on this one. We're plugged into a dummy load, and what happened was when I plugged in the external battery, the noise went up, and I thought it was because the charger was on. So we've got the charger setting on. Yeah, and you can hear it, and you can see the noise floor raise up when we plug in the external power supply. So let's go over and turn the charger off. All right, I heard it go back down, and it did drop a little bit, but it didn't go down all the way. Now we're fully unplugged, and it dropped another bar, 2 bars, back up to 1 bar, back down to 2 bars. So it's hunting somewhere around that 1 to 2. Let's plug the shore power back in, and we just jumped up. Okay, so there's definitely some noise. This is an Astron RS35A, which is, Astron's a good power supply name. We did test it on battery out in the field, and that's what it did. So now I want to do that same test on the production unit. Plug this one here back in. Let's switch it over to lower sideband. Yes, it's 20 meters, and I'm using lower sideband. It doesn't matter. I'm plugged into a dummy load, and I am not transmitting. Okay, so setting, where's our charger? Our charger is off. Our noise floor is dead. Same frequency, same dummy load for an antenna. Okay, so they fixed that in the production unit. Fantastic. I'm not gonna be able to get better than none. Let's leave that at 5. Let's turn that charger on. There we go. Charger on, no noise impacts. Charger off, no noise impacts. And again, I'm looking at the power meter. Let's zoom it in there. So the signal strength meter right there has one white bar. That's the peak hold function. And if I turn the power on, charger on, it doesn't move. If I turn it off, it doesn't move. The other thing that I noticed was the sensitivity on these guys. Sometimes when you turn it, okay, so like hands off, it's on TX power. I'm gonna just start turning. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1. That was one turn, no move. Two turns. Okay, so it's specifically set for every two clicks that it's gonna move. So you can kind of feel that. And if I start turning fast, okay, that's what it is. It has ballistics. Let's zoom back out. It has what you would call ballistics. I had to do air quotes twice, now three times. So if you turn it slow, it lets you go slow. And if you turn it faster, it jumps. So that's actually a good behavior. I have no problem with that. Just to be fair to the other radio, we had pre on or off, I don't remember. Let's turn pre on. Okay, pre is on. Exit, so there's your preamp. And we're still at one bar with the charger off. And now it's not changing at all. Let's go back here, leave the preamp on. And we're at, it doesn't say charger on or off. It says charger on there. Let's select it again. There it is, charger on, off. On, no noise change, still one bar, and then back off. Okay, so they've fixed that problem, and that is with the preamp on, just to be, you know, kind to the other radio, because I bumped that setting when we were going through it before. The other thing I wanted to share with you is the manual. Now, instead of being printed out on your own printer and stapled together at the top, it's actually on glossy paper, and it is somewhat bound. So there's two staples in the side for binding, and it's the traditional binding method where there are staples that run through the center of the book. So there's the internal center. So they sent this out to a print shop to have this printed. So there you have it. That is the end of that test. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comments down below. I personally am not terribly happy with the power output. It just seems like takes it a little while to get up to full power. Once it's up to full power, it'll stay if you're on it. But in a traditional SSB QSO, there's enough time between, you know, on key and off key when you're listening to the other side that it's gonna drop back down a bit and have to warm up again. Will it make much difference in your QSOs? You guys heard the QSOs that I attempted to make during our really bad solar cycle that we're having right now, a really bad solar storm that we had a couple of weekends ago, and I was heard, it was fine, it did the job. That was at 4 watts, which is already hard enough to do. So it is what it is, folks. This radio still has some really interesting features about it. It still has some nice things about it. There has been some controversy that if you have a 6100, should you upgrade to a 6200? I'm not sure yet. This has direct up conversion and direct down conversion inside of its receiver, and I need to find out a good way to test what that actually means in a meaningful way that I can show on a video. So stay tuned for that. Also, we're gonna start doing some FT8 work on this, so stay tuned for that as well. There's a video right over here I think you'll enjoy next. Thanks for being awesome. I'll see you over there.